All right, so for today's question of the day is, what habit makes you you?
I read every night before I go to bed.
I make sure I talk to my boyfriend every single night before I go to bed.
Yay!
Hey homies, so this is my 10 habits that basically make me me, or that I've gotten really used to doing, and I just wanted to share them with you, so here they are. So for the first hobby that I have down is my morning routine. Basically, I'll wake up, go to the bathroom, wash my face, and then that leads me to go make breakfast, which is normally either avocado toast, banana and peanut butter toast, I'm not quite sure what that would be called, or oatmeal if I don't have either of those. So then after breakfast, I'll come in and make my bed. I really like making my bed. It's just like a kind of ease of mind type thing, just having my bed made. But after that, I'll then go put on the clothes I laid out the night before, and that will lead me to go brush my teeth and put on deodorant. And then for the final thing of my morning routine, I will come in and I will work on my journals or my planner. That kind of just organizes the rest of my day. And I like visualizing what I have to do that day and checking things off. So that will lead us to our second habit. So the second habit of the day is journaling. I didn't always used to do a lot of journaling. The first journal of the five that I showed you is basically halfway through high school till college. So it wasn't every day that I wrote in it, because they're only about 180 pages or so. I now write every day, if not every other day. And in the morning routine, I write, every morning I write three things I'm grateful for. I really like doing that, and it's really become a big habit that if I don't do it, it's kind of like I'm missing something in the morning. But then it's also cool to like look back on all the things of like different holidays, different events, and just being like, oh yeah, I totally remember that. And like certain things are simply just listing what happened in the day, but there's others like a big day and I'll write down like what happened. And so basically it's just keeping a log of what happened in life or the cool lessons that I've learned. And that is the second habit I have. Alright, so now for habit number three, which is meditating. I will explain basically how I meditate, which is through this app. It's called Simple Habit. I don't know if you guys can see that. There's a better reflection. But basically, I'll meditate in the morning most days, and that's part of my morning routine, is just as soon as I wake up, put on a meditation, and just, it's like, before I get started with anything in my day, I'll do that meditation, and it's easier because there's not as many thoughts normally that go through that, like go through the morning process. But I could be sitting in my car and just need like 2 minutes. I do that when I'm at my desk too, while I may get overwhelmed with homework. Then that's a big thing with my meditations, is the breath behind it. So that's habit number three. Alright, now habit number four, which is drinking water. I drink water at least 150 ounces a day, and that varies between if I have games, practices, or what, but like the goal is 150 ounces per day, and I normally hit that, and I carry one water bottle with me pretty much everywhere, and I'll have my volleyball water bottle, I've had a lot of water bottles, I guess. But basically, it's just, I'll drink water with every meal, so breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And then I try to just have it on me at all times. And I notice I can feel really bad or icky if I'm not hydrated. So just having water on me at all times is really
just the habit that I've gotten into.
I don't know what happens next. Every time I make plans, seem the plans don't stick. And I don't like to talk about my feelings if I could have a word.
Okay, so now we are in habit number 5. This is just staying connected with like family, friends, really anyone. I believe that this life isn't meant to be lived alone. So I call my dad every Monday and we just talk and catch up and see how each other are doing because I don't live at home. And then every Wednesday I call my brother, and that's usually accompanied by my cousin Courtney, and that's about almost anything. So just again catching up with them too, and then basically just like texting people daily or just asking random questions to check in. I know that it can be hard or sometimes seem unintentional when that happens, but basically just like talking to them and like genuinely caring what that response is to whatever question you ask them. But I talk to my stepdad quite often and just see how home is, and he always checks up on me. And my Papa Sketty, he texts me every day with a quote, and we're almost on 1,000 quotes, which is absolutely insane to me. He started it when I came to college, and so that's just, it's really cool to have someone care that much about you and just be there for you, and yeah, it's great. Now for habit number 6, it's keeping everything organized, which that keeps me like sane, and I love when things are organized basically. So I have a planner that I basically live by, and I mark almost everything down in there, and that's based off what I have to do for school, for volleyball, and I write down daily what is like on my agenda through, I have my calendar on my phone / my laptop that I keep up to date with that, and so every morning I write down what I have to do that day and the next day. And then basically I really just like having things put together. And another thing that people may laugh at is I use a table of contents for pretty much everything except for like my daily journal, but like my volleyball journal, my school journals, or my school notebooks, and I'm trying to think of another one, even my YouTube notebook or idea book, I have a table of contents. So I just like knowing where things are, and there's always something to do. Like, you're always asked of something to do, so just knowing and keeping track of that is easy for me, or I like that. So that's my habit number 6.
Not today. I just want to make the most of this life. Sometimes I wonder if I'm doing it right. Everyone's a little broken sometimes, and that's fine. I don't want to spend the rest of my days worrying about the things I can't change.
All right, so that leads us to habit number 7, which is basically having goals or milestones up around. For me, I have one on my bathroom mirror, on a spot next to my computer at my desk that I sit at every day. I have a little reminder on my journal. I have one on my computer screen. It's kind of like more of a mantra that I like to read every day. But there's tons of like people that have like vision boards, and like if you go on YouTube, it like there's a lot of like, I will like to watch TED Talks, but there's a lot of them that are like talking about the importance of goal setting. And some of these goals can be like long-term or short-term. And short-term, I kind of think of more of like milestones, like you hit them to then get to your long-term goals. And like being in college, it's kind of hard to like think of like, what do I really want to do after college? It's an intimidating thing to think about, but having these milestones to eventually lead up to something that I'd like to do is helpful to me. And it is a good feeling to check it off, but I'm sure everyone's always talked about this. It's a lot of it is about the journey getting to that point, and that's the good part of it. So just having these goals and milestones put up as a reminder is just, it's good for like the brain to remember it basically. All right, so now for habit number 8, which is basically like a physical check-in. So I'll either go on walks, which are normally on the weekends, or unless it gets better out, then I'll go
on the weekdays. It just depends on my schedule. And then another one is like doing yoga, which is also more on the weekends. But I do stretch every day after practice, and that's just knowing, like, having like a mind and physical connection of like knowing when your body feels good and being able to like reset with a breath, and like you'll understand your body more. And as an athlete, we do a lot of things to make our skills better and perform at a certain high level. So just any little bit that can help me is what I look for. Alright, so now for my last two habits. Number 9 is social media, which it isn't the habit, but talking about social media is basically on my phone. Like, I won't have social media apps where I can like right away like click on them. I'll have to go into a folder, then click on them, which helps me also talk about or have a purpose with why I'm clicking the app. So instead of just randomly and mindlessly clicking and scrolling, I'm like, okay, why do I actually want to go on here? Which brings me up to an article that I was reading about by Forbes. It talks about, the title of it is 6 Ways Social Media Affects Our Mental Health. And one of them, if you scroll down, it talks about comparing our lives with others is mentally unhealthy. I think if you use social media, but in a good, like, sense or a good amount, then it's not harmful. So for me, it's like I have a rule with myself that I don't click on any social media before breakfast, so that at least however long my morning is, I will have that part to myself and I won't have to think about the comparing factor that I may do subconsciously. So that's my social media habit. All right, so now my last habit of my 10 habits is putting my phone up before bed. You guys already saw in my morning routine how my phone is away from my bed, or at least I have to get up out of bed to unplug it or stop the alarm. This is just so when I put it down, I'm not laying in bed and scrolling. And yes, there are some nights where I'll bring my laptop into bed, watch a movie, or do mindless activities with it. But for the most part, to have this as a habit, I will put my phone on my desk, and if I absolutely need it, then there will obviously be a need to get out of bed and look up something or answer a phone call or whatever it may be. So basically, it's just unplugging, how people say, and like putting that away for the night. And yeah, that's my last habit. All right, so that concludes the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. And don't forget to spread love, homies. We're gonna start over, because apparently I like to sit at home. Hear that I sit at a desk, at my desk every day. Restart. Why can't I speak today? Always have that constant reminder of having something to look at. So now for our last two habits.